In Africa, yes. Yes, because there is a policy. The CE of the American government is called the Kissinger Report, which was produced in the mid-70s when Henry Kissinger was involved with the government. And it explicitly states, which to this day, it remains the official policy of the American government. It has not changed.
Mm-hmm.
It may not be implemented by Trump, but it remains the same. That the purpose of the foreign policy in Africa was to reduce the population. So to give aid to countries in Africa, not clean water and schooling and things like that, but contraception and abortion, in order to shrink the population of Africa, because they have great mineral resources there.
That sounds diabolical.
Yes.
That sounds like something conceived in the mind of Margaret Sanger.
Yeah, definitely.
This mineral is found in every plane, every car, every cell phone. And it's mined on the world's fourth largest island, Madagascar, located off the coast of East Africa. It is a country known for its lush forests and its vast wildlife. What it is lesser known for are the thousands of children working in the country's mica industry. Trapped in a cycle of extreme poverty and exploitation, workers, some as young as 4 years old, are tasked with mining the material in conditions that are anything but safe. NBC's Cynthia McFadden traveled to the poorest region of Madagascar, where a vast majority of the mica mining takes place.
In a forgotten corner of Madagascar, deep inside a bat-filled cave, miners are finishing up a 14-hour day.
How old are they? Eight.
They work 7 days a week. None of them go to school. If they don't dig, they don't eat. See those holes? Every one a 50-foot airless mica pit. And in nearly every hole, a child.
Joining me now, NBC News Senior Investigative Correspondent Cynthia McFadden. Cynthia, you did 9 minutes on this, on the Today Show this morning. The story is much longer than what we just showed. What did you find out?
Well, I mean, Katie, some of the world's richest and most profitable countries depend upon children for the very products that they sell or that they use. And to actually be present with these kids and their families was really overwhelming.
It's crawling with children. This is one of the thousands of unregulated, unmonitored mines in the DRC. It's crawling with children working like modern-day slaves. A 12-hour-long day of punishing work may earn them the equivalent of a pound. Although one of the poorest countries on Earth, DRC is rich in minerals. But a history of brutal colonial exploitation looks like being repeated now in 2017. Much of it's mined by hand with rudimentary tools in harsh, potentially hazardous conditions. And wretched weather or not, the rush is on for a mineral the DRC has in great abundance, cobalt, and it's fast becoming more precious than gold. It's a critical ingredient in lithium-ion batteries which power smartphones and laptops. An army of children are at the heart of the mining production. Wearing no shoes and in the most wretched conditions, Dorsan is ordered to retrieve the sack he's forgotten. There's an urgency now. The rains make this dangerous work even more risky. Dorsan's told in no uncertain terms he risks a beating if he messes up again. Dorsan, with Richard beside him, have worked all day.
So it's needed to manufacture things like smartphones, laptops, and electric cars. But human rights groups say often those miners are children, and the working conditions can be deadly. Often the miners have to dig by hand, deep inside tunnels without any safety equipment.
They tunnel straight down and 50 meters sometimes into the shale. We heard stories of up to 65 people in one incident, including adults and children, were buried alive and they didn't even find their bodies yet.
There are no official statistics on fatalities, But miners have told human rights groups that they risk injury or death whenever they work in unregulated mines. Now Congolese families want to hold Apple, Google, Dell, Tesla, and Microsoft accountable. A US-based human rights nonprofit is suing the tech giants on behalf of 14 families. It's the first time the tech industry has faced legal action over the mining of cobalt.
And that my 14 clients are either children who have been maimed or the parents of children who have been killed in mining accidents, which are very routine. There's a boy with an amputated leg. There's several boys with smashed legs. They'll never work again in the Democratic Republic of Congo, and they need medical attention.
According to both, how do you expect this to be addressed?
Well, the population growth issue at the global level is not that daunting. That is, the population percentage-wise is growing slower today than in the past, and so it will actually peak out. The problem is that the population is growing the fastest where people are less able to deal with it. So it's in the very poorest places that you're going to have a tripling in population by 2050. And so their ability to feed, educate, provide jobs, stability, protect the environment in those locations mean they're faced with an almost impossible problem. Northern Nigeria, Yemen, Chad. And so what we need to do is take this aid generosity and this innovation and go into those places, offer the women better tools where they want to space birthing or have a smaller family size, and improve health, because it's amazingly, as children survive, parents feel like they'll have enough kids to support them in their old age, and so they choose to have less children. Niger right now, it's still 7 children per family, whereas in the richer countries, you're often at a stable point of which is 2.1 or even less. And so it's really an acute problem in a certain number of places, and we've got to make sure that we help out with the tools now so that they don't have an impossible situation later.
Unbelievable.